إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed the most truthful of speech and the best of words are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم and the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها and the worst of affairs are those things when you invent into this religion of ours وكل محدثة بدعة and everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation وكل بدعة ضلالة And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدِ My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we constantly remind ourselves in this month with the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ The month of Ramadan in which the Qur'an was revealed. This Qur'an is the guidance for mankind. And there's clear proofs upon proofs upon proofs that Allah gave us for that guidance. And the criterion between what is right and what is wrong, what is halal, what is haram, what is permissible, what is impermissible for us. Everything is in this book that suffices guidance to be led to Jannah. Allah says, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا Allah says, what means verily this Qur'an, this book we have that is the actual speech of our Creator and our Lord. Not a created book, it's His actual speech that He spoke. This guides to that which is most just and what is right. And it gives glad tidings to those believers in Tawheed. Who believe in the oneness of Allah and the messengership of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who work deeds of righteousness, that they will have a promise that Jannah will be their hereafter abode, that will be their great reward. But there are those who don't take heed to this, and on the day of resurrection, Allah, He will have Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, "What means?" وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا The Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will say on the day of resurrection, "O my Lord, my people, the ones who said La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, the ones who claimed to follow Islam and this deen and took me as their example, my Lord, my people deserted this Quran. They didn't listen to it. They didn't act upon its laws or its orders. They didn't take what was recommended in it. And this would be one of the greatest sadnesses, if not the greatest sadness, to reach that day living a life." Where we thought we were doing, living the Qur'an in action, and we weren't doing that at all. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this Qur'an is filled with many powerful messages. Ones to remind us of the little value of this life, of this dunya, and of the great value of the akhirah. The great value that comes, because that is the better life. That is the life that is eternal. And one of those messages, although we may think we hear about it enough, we don't really understand the true value, the true blessing, the true favor Allah bestowed on us by the fact that we could give charity in His cause. So let us remind ourselves with this benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, هَا أَنْتُمْ هَا أُولَٰئِ تُدْعَوْنَ لِتُنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ Allah says in the Quran what means, behold you, you Muslims, you who claim to follow La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, you are the ones who've been called to stand in the cause of Allah. Anyone who withholds, anyone who's tight-fisted from this spending, then they will only do so at the expense of his or her own self. No one is going to spend in the cause of Allah except one who truly believes in Allah and His Messenger ﷺ and in Islam. If we don't, who will? Will it be the governments? No. Will it be the disbelievers? No. So it is the ones who hold fast to this deen that must spend in the cause of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah says what means, those who spend their wealth in Allah's cause, by night and by day, they're always looking for some khair, some good to do, to spend in the way of Allah, and to spend in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in secret and in public. Not everything was meant to be secretive, because the public sadaqah sometimes encourages others to also give. Those who do so, they will have a reward with their Lord. They shall have no fear, nor shall they grieve or be afraid on that day of resurrection, because they gave in the cause of Allah. ثم قال الله آمنوا بالله ورسوله وأنفقوا مما جعلكم مستخلفين فيه فالذين آمنوا منكم وأنفقوا لهم أجر كبير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says what means, believe in Allah and believe in His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And He tied to this belief something very important and special. In this case, and spend in the way of Allah and His cause with the wealth that He made you a trustee. I don't care if you show me a bank statement or land papership ownership or grant deeds or whatever they're called that show that you own this much or have this much. All of this is an amana from Allah. It's a trust from Allah to see what you'll do with it. None of it you take with you to your grave unless you spent it in the right way. Spend of what we have given you, of what we made you trustees, and such of you who believe, and spend in the cause of Allah, then there will be a great reward. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we do not want to be in that position where we have to, quote unquote, beg or ask to return back to this life after we have left it, just so we can spend. Allah says, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّي لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتِنِي إِلَىٰ أَجْلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He warns us of this, to not be of these people. He says, spend in charity of what we have provided for you, because what you're giving is really Allah's in the first place. Do not fool yourself to think it's your wealth. Before death comes to one of you, and the person says, when death comes to him and takes him, my Lord, if only you'll just give me a little more time, just send me back. This ayah specifically says, send me back so I can give in charity at that time. This is the importance of that charity and that sadaqah, to purify the wealth, to give it what Allah made you a trustee with, to give it in the cause of Allah. Send me back for a little while to the worldly life. I will give sadaqah from my wealth and be amongst those who do righteous deeds, like performing hajj and the likes of these matters. On one occasion, the Prophet ﷺ, he said to the people who will aid the army of Usra. So Uthman ibn Affan, the great Sahabi, the one who was promised Jannah, he was already promised Jannah. He went to his home and he came back with 1,000 dinar. This is kilograms of gold. Kilograms, not a gram, kilograms of gold. And he came and put him in the lap of the Prophet ﷺ. Driven by ayat like, لَن تَنَالُ الْبِرِّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. He was driven by these ayat that you will not achieve the reward of Jannah. And this was the ones promised it already. You will not achieve the reward of Jannah till you give from that which you love the most. And surely Allah is all knowledgeable of those who give in His cause the good that you spend. Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about an ayah in the Quran. She said, what is with respect to this ayah? وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ. What about this ayah? Those who give what they give while their hearts are afraid. She said, is this referring to those who drink intoxicants or take drugs or do these things or steal? So the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لا يا بنت الصديق ولكنهم الذين يصومون ويصلون ويتصدقون وهم يخافون أن لا يقبلوا منهم أولئك الذين يسارعون في الخيرات. This hadith, which is Hassan, Sahih Afwan, according to Sheikh Al-Albani, in the Sunan of Tirmidhi, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, no, the one who gives while their heart is afraid, they are the ones. He said, oh, my daughter of the truthful one, meaning her father, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, radiallahu anhu. Rather, they are those who fast, they are those who pray, they are those who give in charity, but they fear that it will not be accepted from them. They are the ones who race towards virtue. So many times we give as if we know that Allah has already accepted it from us, with no doubt and no question in our mind or in our heart, despite us knowing that many times our motives is to restrain or to hold back. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us what we reminded ourselves a few weeks ago with as-sadaqatu burhan. You want to prove your faith to Allah, then you have to give. And Bani Adam, the children of Adam, they love wealth, they love money, it's comfort to them, it's happiness to them, although it's an illusion and a delusion. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, give in the way of Allah. This is burhan. This is a proof of your iman, a proof of your faith. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل امرئ في ظل صدقاته حتى يفصل بين الناس. This hadith, which we find in the collection of a hadith from Ibn Hibban and Hakim, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, every person will be in the shade of his or her sadaqah until Allah decides and judges between the people. That day, يَوْمًا كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةً, the day of resurrection, 50,000 years long, the sun overhead, no clothing, naked, circumcised, waiting to be questioned by Allah on that day, which is that 50,000 years long, running from your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, your spouse, your children, a day of fear, a day of calamity, a day of disaster for many, but some are given shade. Everything you give in the way of Allah, imagine it's like sewing every dollar to make a tent, a canopy, a hat for yourself to protect you on that day. This is your sadaqah. It will be made to be a cover for you, to protect you from the torment of that day. May Allah protect us from it. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the guidance of the Quran has given us a gift, not a burden. It has given us a blessing and a favor, not a hardship with respect to charity. Because through it, our sins are removed. Through it, we can attain or help us attain Allah's mercy and Jannah. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa radahum, may Allah be pleased with them. They would look, not wait for someone to come and ask. They would go and look for ways that they could give in the path of Allah. They would be troubled when there was nothing that they would hear of so that they could go give in the cause of Allah. They would seek extra work so they could give in the cause of Allah. We run from the opportunity to give, because we say, well, I have so much to give, I have so much to do, I have to spend my money here, I want to still go do this. It's all good and dandy. But you're only hurting yourself potentially in the Akhirah. We speak of all these things, we make excuses, we even sometimes abandon causes where we know that money will be sought to help the Muslims or a situation of the Muslims. We even get to the point where we're frustrated with the amount of times money may be sought, and it's all for what? For the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who created us and blessed us and gave us reward after reward. So I want us all in this time to remember some ayat we read in Qiyam a few days ago when we were reading Surah Al-A'raf. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, regarding the people of Jannah, the paradise, and the people of Jahannam, that between them will be a barrier, and on it will be high places, elevated places. وَبَيْنَهُمَا حِجَابٌ وَعَلَى الْأَعْرَافِ رِجَالٌ يَعْرِفُونَ كُلَّ بِسِيمَاهُمْ كُلًّا بِسِيمَاهُمْ وَنَادَوْا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ لَمْ يَدْخُلُوهَا وَهُمْ يَطْمَعُونَ. Allah says, what means, and between the people of Jannah, paradise, and the hellfire, there is a barrier screen, and on al-A'raf, raised walls with raised high places, will be men. What is the characteristic of their dunya life? Their good deeds and their evil deeds are equal in weight. Imagine having been blessed with this deen, being blessed with salah, being blessed with sadaqah, being blessed with dhikr, things that can make our scales so heavy so we're not in the situation of the people of Al-A'raf. on those places where the good deeds and the bad deeds are equal. Imagine, just because of withholding in this life, that you will be delayed entry into Jannah, or potentially go to the hellfire, because you withhold giving in the cause of Allah. They will recognize, even though they're on that wall, they will recognize the people of Jannah by their marks, and the people of the hellfire by their marks. The people of Jannah, the bright white faces. The people of Jahannam, the dark faces of fear. They will call out to the dwellers of paradise, "Salamun alaykum, peace be unto you." And at that time, the men of Al-A'raf will not have yet entered Jannah, but they will hope to enter it. وَإِذَا صُرِفَتْ أَبَصَارُهُمْ تِلْقَاءَ أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ قَالُوا رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا مَعَ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. And when their eyes then are turned to the people of Jahannam, to the people of the hellfire, they will turn and say, "O Lord, place us not with the people who were zalimun, who were wrongdoers and polytheists." وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ الْأَعْرَافِ رِجَالًا يَعْرِفُونَهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ قَالُوا مَا أَغْنَى عَنْكُمْ جَمْعُكُمْ وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Then the people of Al-A'raf on this wall, again, their characteristic, their good deeds and their bad deeds were equal. We cannot have that be our situation. When there is so much good we can do to make our scales so heavy of good, to erase some of our sins at the same time. The men of Al-A'raf, they will call unto the men whom they should recognize by their marks, saying, "Of what benefit was the great hoards that you had of this wealth? Of what benefit was the great wealth you had in the dunya? Of what benefit was the great amount of land you owned in the dunya? Of what benefit was the great amount of jewelry that you hoarded in this dunya? Of what benefit was all that money that you hoarded and you kept for yourself in this dunya? What benefit was to you? And your arrogance will be against your, and your arrogance was against your faith. What was it? To what benefit? And there will be no benefit for them." The people of Jahannam are classified, الَّذِينَ اتَّخِذُونَ دِينُهُمْ لَهْوًا وَلَعِبًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا وَمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَجْحَدُونَ. Allah says regarding the people of Jahannam, they are those who took their religion as an amusement, as a play, and the life of this world deceived them. So this day, we shall forget them as they forgot meeting us on this day, and they used to reject our ayat. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah gave us so many ways to save ourselves from situations like this. So do not think twice about giving in the way of Allah, because it could be the difference between you being on that high place, looking up at the people of Jannah, and looking down at the people of Jahannam, recognizing them by their faces. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما تصدق أحد بصدقة من طيب ولا يقبل الله إلا طيب إلا الطيب إلا أخذه الرحمن بيمينه وإن كانت طمرة فترضو في كف الرحمن حتى تكون أعظم من الجبل. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in his authentic hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, he said, "No one gives sadaqah from that which is good. And Allah only accepts that what is good and pure, except that Ar-Rahman, the entirely merciful, the creator of the heavens and the earth, who is above his arsh, which is above the seven heavens and the earth, separate from his creation. He will take that which you give in his right hand, even if it is a date of sadaqah, of a charity, and he will nurture it and grow it till it becomes the size of a mountain. This is an investment that will never have a loss. It is only one that will grow way more exponentially than any gain could come in this life. No more. So when you give in the way of Allah, it doesn't go into the hand of an imam. It doesn't go into a box. It doesn't go into a bank account. It goes into the hand of your Creator, and He will multiply it and grow the reward for you so that your scales can be heavy on that day of judgment. So give in the way of Allah, so you can enter min bab as-sadaqah, from the gate of Jannah, of the eight gates of Jannah, you can enter from the gate of those who gave in the way of Allah. Know that you're putting everything you give in the right hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you need a little more, we can give you more. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Give in the way of Allah. Spend in the way of Allah. Protect yourself from the hellfire, even if it's with a piece of date. Because all of that sadaqah is removal of sins, and it is protection from that hellfire. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَتَّقُوا الشُّحَّةَ فَإِنَّ الشُّحَّةَ أَهْلَكَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ. The Prophet ﷺ, he said in this hadith in Sahih Muslim, beware of stinginess, because it was being stingy that destroyed the people before you. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مَا مِنْ يَوْمٍ يُصْبِحُ الْعِبَادَ فِيهِ إِلَّا مَلَكَانِ يَنْزِلَانِ يَقُولُ أَحَدُهُمَا اللَّهُمَّ أَعْطِي مُنْفِقًا خَلَفًا وَيَقُولُ الْآخِرُ اللَّهُمَّ أَعْطِي مُمْسِكًا تَلَفًا. This hadith that we have in Sahih al-Bukhari, a beautiful narration. And why do we always remind each other of this hadith? Because I don't think we comprehend the reality of the malaika, the angels, the ones who mark our deeds over our right and left shoulders, the ones who guard us switching posts by fajr and by asr times, in front of us and behind us, guiding us to what is correct. I don't think we understand the reality of those angels, that creation of Allah made out of light, just because we don't see them. But it is a promise and a truth from Allah that every day that the sun rises, two angels, they come out and they make a dua for or against the one who gives and the one who withholds. One of them says, "Oh Allah, give to the one who gave in your cause today." And the other one says, "Oh Allah, withhold and destroy from the one who withholds in charity today." An angel of Allah made of nur, making this dua every day when the day breaks. Every morning, two angels make one for you or against you when it comes to giving in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, know that sadaqah that is best to Allah is when you're capable, when you're healthy, when you're prosperous, but you're fearing poverty. This is the best time to give. وَالصَّدَقَةُ تُطْفِئُ الْخَطِيَةُ كَمَا يُطْفِئُ الْمَاءُ النَّارُ. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said in the authentic hadith that charity extinguishes and wipes away your sins just like water extinguishes and wipes away a fire. May Allah make us of those who give in His cause. Amen. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we can go on and on. The ayat are plentiful, the ahadith even more plentiful. The generosity of the implementation of the Quran and the Sunnah of the companions, unbelievable. It makes your eyes just tear seeing how much they gave and how much they wanted to continue to give in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now again comes our time to pay Allah debts that we owe Him, to release that burden of the trust that He has put to us. Allah, He says, Inna Allah ashtara min al-mu'mineena anfusuhum wa amwalahum bi anna lahum al-jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, what means? Verily Allah has purchased of the believers their lives and their wealth. They belong to Allah. But Allah is so just and fair that He purchased the lives and the wealth and the properties of the believers. He didn't mention the Muslims here. He didn't mention mankind. He mentioned those who are believers with Him. For them the price that theirs shall be paradise. Jannah in return for giving back to Allah what He gave you as a trust. So who is refusing to sell this dunya life to Allah in return for Jannah? Allah saying, giving me what I entrusted you with, and I will give you Jannah in return. عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس وكان أجود ما يكون في رمضان حين يلقاه جبريل وكان يلقاه في كل ليلة من رمضان فيدارسه القرآن. فلرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود بالخير من الريح المرسلة. This hadith, which is in Bukhari, Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he says, Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was the most generous of people, of all people. And he used to be even more generous and the most of generous people during the month of Ramadan when Jibreel عليه السلام would meet him. No, it didn't just say on Laylat al-Qadr or on the day of Eid or at the end of Ramadan. It mentioned Ramadan as a whole because there's no guarantee that we'll live to even tonight to make it to break our fast or to make Qiyam or whatever it may be. You even saw the news, this basketball star or whatever from college, 19 years old, visiting in Los Angeles, has the NBA in his future, going to the draft, and a car accident takes his life. No one's guaranteed to live an hour in this life, a minute in this life, young or old, healthy or sick. So he was the most generous during Ramadan. When Jibreel met him, Jibreel alayhi salam, he used to meet him every night to teach him the Quran. And Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the most generous of persons, even more generous than the strong, uncontrollable wind. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we know from the authentic hadith, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانِ انْقَتَعَ عَامَلَهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. When a person dies, all of their deeds come to an end except for three. صَدَقَةٍ جَارِيَةٍ, the ongoing charity. The charity you give that even when you're dead, people still benefit from what you put into. People still benefit from the masajid, the schools, even the traffic signal that we're going to talk about in a couple of minutes. Why? Because it is a source for Muslims to reach a destination of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will be a source of people to make it to Jum'ah, to make it to prayers, to cross safely. And so in this case, it is an ongoing charity. عِلْمٍ يَنْتَفِعَ بِهِ, knowledge which benefits the people. This is a source that will benefit you even after you have passed. And وَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُوا لَهِ, and a righteous child who makes dua for you. May Allah protect and make all of our children righteous and upon the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll end this reminders with just reminding ourselves that a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and asked him, can I give sadaqah on behalf of my mother and she will receive the reward? And he said na'am. He said, of course, yes, you may do so. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have today again another opportunity in this blessed month. And it's always something that we always hold back from, asking for money. It's not for us. It's for your own self to benefit from. This will be for you or against you. The angels were out this morning making the dua, give to the one who gives, withhold from the one who withholds. Long story short, you don't see what's going on across there because underground work, if you're in construction, you know, it costs the most. Hundreds of thousands of dollars are buried under that sand because of your donations. Water, electricity, sewer, all of these things are buried there, ready for that next phase to put in the parking lot and then the building. All the money for the parking spaces was raised. It's still saved and there to be done. That will done. What gets delays is construction and permits and these other things that we have no control over. But inshallah, by the summer, we'll be all in. But it cannot be used or utilized until we put in the traffic signal. What triggered the traffic signal for the academy was not the school. What triggered it was that they knew that the masjid would be using it for parking on Jum'ah. We can't guarantee the church for another week. They keep expanding certain functions they have, and at any time they could say you can't park here anymore. And yet we've proven week in and week out that parking is not even enough. We have some brothers, some sisters who come to Jum'ah late. May Allah help them to come earlier on time. But we understand the struggles everyone goes through to get to Jum'ah in this non-Muslim land. The encouragement, try to come on time before the imam takes the minbar. But we know it's a struggle. But we should help our brothers and sisters who have those harder situations, ease their struggles. And the way to do that, and for a way for you to do it for yourself if you come late, is to help put in this traffic signal. The city of Manteca approved this past Tuesday, sharing the cost 50-50. They did not have to do that. It was a lot of back and forth work with them, a lot of mutual discussion with them. They know we took on a burden that the city and county and state had for years, with that property being contaminated, etc. It's all been cleaned up and done with. So they met halfway, but we won't get reimbursed for it for a while. And the permit will expire. We have a short window of time to put this traffic signal in. Meaning, next week, we have to give the green light for them to start it, whether we have the money or not. This traffic signal, it's not just that, there's asphalt, concrete. Long story short, $360,000 is the cost that the city is going to share with us, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. We split it up on 120. So each traffic signal that you see on this poster is $3,000. If 120 people come with $3,000, it's done for and it's paid for. Alhamdulillah, we just wait for get completed. If you can't afford that, you have friends, you have family. If you come with 100, you can make phone calls. Not one person, not five people, not 10 people, not just the board has to be responsible for these things. Everyone who you ask to give, you get reward for what they give because you were the source of them giving that. You helped lead them toward that khair. So you'll get the reward and they will get the reward for it. Each light, red, yellow, green, is 1,000 if you can't do the 3,000. But if you can't do the 3,000, I'm asking you and pleading with you to reach out to families and friends. Forward them the messages. Because anything they give because you sent it to them will also be a reward for you. The credit card machines are here. I need 2 minutes of your time after Jum'ah to make dua and see what you can give in the way of Allah, and let's try and fundraise this. It shouldn't be hard, because this is all going back to the one who gave it to you. And Allah will replace it for you. I was speaking with a brother, and he was saying, well, I was going to do this, but I have to send my family here this summer and this night. That's all great and done. Still give what you should give. Still give what you should give. Allah will provide for you. And never doubt that you're putting it in His right hand, and He's going to nurture it and grow it for you. So after the salah, stand by us. The credit card machines are here. There are flyers. There's a QR code that you can scan with the camera of your phone and donate via PayPal that way. All of it is tax deductible, and you'll get a receipt for it at the end of the year, inshallah. So please, make dua for this project to get to this fruition. This is our masjid's duty. That signal is triggered by our Jum'ah services. So we should be the ones who step up. Ha antum ha'ula'i tud'auna litunfiqu fi sabilillah. As Allah said, behold, you are the ones who have been asked to give in the way of Allah. If you don't, who will? اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا تقبل منا قيامنا وتقبل منا صدقاتنا وتقبل منا دعاءنا وسجودنا وركوعنا يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.